Families who have assets of over $20 million are subject to estate tax. And the estate tax at the moment is about 40%. Now, another thing that's happening is in 2026, that law is set to change and drop it from about over $20 million to just over $12 million. So there's going to be a reduction in the amount that doesn't get taxed. And everything above that under the current laws taxed at 40%. And clients with this kind of wealth are concerned about that, and they wonder what to do about it. I mean, some people just buy insurance in a trust so that they have the money to pay for it. But we've learned over the years that I've been in this industry that is the estate tax is a voluntary tax. There was actually a book written by the Brookings Institute back in the 70s that did a study of families who paid a lot of estate tax and families who didn't, and they wanted to know what the difference was. And like the DuPont family paid very little estate tax. And there was another very well-known family at the time, back then the estate tax was 70%, that paid, their entire estate was taxed at 70%. Well, you fast forward to modern times, and the Walton family, Sam Walton died with a $65 million estate, and the family only paid tax, $65 billion estate, and the family only paid tax on $3 billion. And the difference from the Brookings Institute study and from the Waltons was the only difference between the families was they planned for it. And you can actually eliminate a great deal, if not all, of your estate tax if you plan to do so, which requires a thing we call settling your estate before you pass away. And it's just a matter of moving assets into various trusts that do not get taxed and are very legal, but they're usually quite complex. And they have to be built in a way that they will withstand the scrutiny of the federal audit. Because like the Walton family, you know, they avoided a $20 or $30 billion estate tax bill. You could bet the IRS looked at it. And after a couple of years, they ruled that whatever they did was all within the law. And I would imagine there are a few minor changes, but for the most part, the estate plan worked. And that's for as far as a hard dollar value of planning, it's remarkable what can be done with high quality estate planning at that level and the ongoing maintenance that's required to make sure that the documents are being complied with.